Welcome to the March 24, 2011 MSF Frontline Reports podcast. Doctors Without Borders, Médecins Sans Frontières, or MSF, is an independent medical humanitarian aid organisation. I'm Alexandra Brown. This week, on World TB Day, the challenge of improving tuberculosis care in Cambodia. Tuberculosis, or TB, is largely forgotten in developed countries these days. Western countries have only a small number of cases each year. About one-third of the global population, however, is estimated to be infected with the tuberculosis mycobacterium, according to the World Health Organization, or WHO. Cambodia is one of the nations where the disease is having a devastating impact. The WHO put Cambodia on its list of the 22 highest burden countries for TB, estimating that 64% of the population is infected with the TB mycobacterium. The WHO also reports that the country has higher TB prevalence and mortality rates than any other country in the Western Pacific region. Tuberculosis is an opportunistic infection. The TB mycobacterium commonly spreads through the air by coughing or sneezing, and then takes advantage of weakened immune systems to activate into TB disease. This is why developing countries have been hit so hard. Poverty, malnutrition, HIV, poor hygiene, and limited access to quality healthcare are all factors that can weaken immune systems, and their prevalence in Cambodia has made the population particularly vulnerable. MSF's Sean Brokenshire brings us this story. Patient names have been changed to protect their privacy.
Kuntia Lun is 21 years old, visibly underweight and struggling for each breath. She is lying on a bed in the provincial hospital of Kampong Cham, a city on the banks of the Mekong River in southeastern Cambodia. About 2 years ago, she became sick with what she thought was a cold. She had a cough that wouldn't go away, but she was working at a rubber plantation and didn't have much money, so she couldn't afford to see a doctor. Only when she began coughing up blood did she realize that she had no other choice. Lun went to a local health center where she was started on treatment for TB. When her health did not improve after 6 months, she was prescribed an additional round of the same treatment. Almost a year and a half after she first became sick, the health center finally referred her to another facility. When she arrived at the MSF-supported TB ward in Kampong Cham Provincial Hospital, Lun was diagnosed with multi-drug-resistant TB, or MDR-TB, which is a form of the disease that, as its name suggests, does not respond to the drugs most commonly used to treat tuberculosis. Following the new diagnosis, she began receiving the correct treatment for free. But the delay in being properly diagnosed had a significant impact on her long-term prognosis. In February this year, MSF's Dr. Adrian Mateau described her situation.
So it's really a pity for this patient. Both her lungs are very, very damaged. She will not be able anymore to have physical activity, to have a normal life. Now she is in the hospital because of severe side effects of the TB drugs. She cannot feed well. She's very malnourished. So drugs are less effective, so we don't know if she will be able to cure or not, and it's very challenging. And all of that because of a failing system and a lack of referral and a problem of access to good care and proper diagnosis.
Patients with MDR-TB do not respond to the most effective TB drugs. So Kuntia Lun had to take less effective, highly toxic second-line drugs in high doses and for much longer. Whereas treatment for normal TB can take 6 months, treatment for MDR-TB lasts 2 years. On top of that, the second-line drugs often have severe side effects, and Lun had to take even more drugs to counteract them. This is what she said in early February.
I have to take about 20 tablets each day. I felt depressed at first, but after I started treatment, I felt better about it. I try to be tolerant. I try to be patient with the drugs, because I know that they only cause me problems in the beginning of my treatment. Then the side effects will disappear.
In 2009, MSF built a TB ward for Kampong Cham Provincial Hospital and upgraded the facility's laboratory. Since then, MSF has been providing staff, training, medicines and material support to the hospital. The goal is to improve its ability to diagnose and treat TB patients effectively. And in the last quarter of 2010, despite the ongoing challenges in improving diagnostic techniques, the TB detection rate at Kampong Cham Hospital rose by 25%. Currently, the team is seeing about 120 patients each week. Roughly one-third of those are new suspected TB cases. Cambodia's TB problems are compounded by poverty. Over 30% of the population lives below the poverty line. Many cannot afford to see a doctor when they become sick. It is only when their illness becomes much worse that they seek treatment at a health facility. Here is Kuntia Lun.
I wouldn't be able to afford treatment if it wasn't free. When I recover, I would like to inform all of my community that if you have some symptoms, like coughing, or other symptoms of TB, that they should come here and get treated free of charge.
MSF supports TB patients in Kampong Cham with free medicines, treatment and transportation when necessary. Since TB often causes weight loss, which further weakens patients' immune systems, MSF provides additional nutrition according to the patient's needs. For those who are malnourished, this includes ready-to-use therapeutic food, a nutrient-rich paste which delivers essential micronutrients to both adults and children. Because they've not yet developed strong immune systems, and it's difficult to diagnose them, children are particularly vulnerable to TB. Dr. Marianne Gale recently returned from Kampong Cham, where she was training the MSF team and Ministry of Health staff in the latest diagnostic techniques. She said TB detection rates among children need to be improved in this region of Cambodia.
It was quite clear that even just visiting some of the wards at the hospital, that there are children there with TB that we're just not able to pick up at the moment. And similarly in the district hospital levels, there are children there that I saw who were quite highly suggestive of having TB. So I think as the project continues to develop, the staff continue to be more aware about paediatric TB, I think the numbers of children being detected and treated here are only going to improve, and that will be really great to see.
Aside from a lack of training for medical staff and the need to raise awareness of the problem, there are a multitude of barriers to detecting TB in children. Dr. Gale.
Firstly, unlike adults, children don't produce many mycobacteria, and that means when they cough, it's very unlikely that you will find mycobacteria in any product that they can produce when they cough. Whereas in adults, a significant proportion of adults, when they cough, you'll be able to find the mycobacteria under a microscope.
TB is usually diagnosed by analysing a patient's sputum, the fluid that comes up from the lungs and which adults can produce when instructed. But it is much more difficult to get this from a young child, says Dr. Gale.
Also in children, we tend to see more of what we call extrapulmonary disease, which means disease that occurs outside the lungs. There's no real test that you can do, and this is one of the biggest barriers at the moment to correctly identifying and treating children with TB, is the lack of a suitable diagnostic test.
Children are not the only ones who have long been without a suitable test. The most commonly used and least expensive TB tests are 130 years old and can take up to a month or more in some cases to produce a result. Other options do exist, including a rapid test, run on a new, fully automated machine. The machine produces fast and accurate diagnostic results from patient sputum. MSF is starting to use this test in some countries and plan to use it in Cambodia in the near future. However, even with a steep discount, the machines are not affordable in many countries, and it is not usable in remote areas. The ideal approach to tackling TB would be a cost-effective point-of-care test, one that could be administered at the health post level without electricity or a laboratory, and that could provide a result in just a few hours.
To have a point-of-care test for TB would really be a game-changer in the world of TB, and especially for children. Right now, there is no good diagnostic test for children. There is no test that really is very helpful for clinicians. Those tests that are available, don't give you often a very clear answer, and B, are not readily available. Even if they are available, are very costly and very difficult to implement.
For now, Emmanuel Loveyville, MSF's head of mission in Cambodia, says MSF's assistance with TB there may be needed for some time.
Knowing that for tuberculosis in particular, you have somehow a situation that is very backward. You have drugs and approaches that are using techniques that are very old and that are somehow not so relevant or not so efficient today, and that are making it a very complicated process for patients, for us.
That backwardness, he said, means that TB will continue to erode the lives of individuals and communities.
You're speaking here of a disease that is impacting the life of tens and tens of thousands in Cambodia. So you're speaking about people that cannot go to school, that cannot learn, that cannot work. It's one of the big challenges in public health-wise in the country today.
This podcast episode is dedicated to Kuntia Lun. After this piece was written, I received the crushing news that Lun, the 21-year-old patient who had suffered with multi-drug-resistant TB, had recently passed away. Unfortunately, she had received MDR-TB treatment too late to save her life. The MSF team is continuing their work to improve detection and treatment strategies for the region and to increase awareness in the community and surrounding medical facilities of the importance of early detection and treatment.
MSF plans to expand its assistance in Kampong Cham province in the next few years, including potentially replicating the approach in a select number of district hospitals to help some marginalised groups in the population to access quality TB care. For more information on this story and to learn more about MSF or Doctors Without Borders, please visit msf.org to find the MSF website in your home country. MSF is an independent medical humanitarian aid organisation that delivers emergency assistance to people affected by wars, epidemics and natural or man-made disasters in more than 60 countries around the world.